Welcome back to the SportsMax Zone. 9 Caribbean teams are slated to take part in the 27th edition of the Goodwill Swimming Championship, set to take place at the National Aquatic Center in Kingston, Jamaica. The 3-day event will begin on Friday afternoon with live coverage of the opening ceremony to be aired live on SportsMax 2, beginning at 4:20 p.m., 5:20 in the Eastern Caribbean. We're pleased to be joined in studio by Dallin Brown, who is the head coach of the Bahamian swim team, as well as Tony Yates, who is a swimmer representing my country, Trinidad and Tobago. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
All right, so I'll start with Tony first. Mm-hmm. Tony, how excited are you, you know, to be here in Jamaica? Is it your first time here in Jamaica?
Yeah, this is my first time.
So how do you like it so far?
So on the first day, they carried us around. We saw the Bob Marley Museum. And I love history, so like I saw about it, and then we saw these painted walls, and it was like really beautiful. I took a few pictures, so I'm just excited to be in a new country on the whole.
Yeah.
I really wish my family could be here, because like traveling without them and experiencing new things without them is kind of like sad.
Do you have a cell phone? The good thing is you could take a lot of pictures and send.
Yeah, I have been.
Yeah. All right. Well, I'm happy that you're here in Jamaica. How has preparations been for the competition? You took part last year. So how have you been preparing for this year?
Mostly mental training. My coach would sit down and talk to me, because before my races, I get really, really anxious. Mm-hmm. So where I envision my race, even on my bed, just closing my eyes and envisioning everything. So on the meet day, I'll know exactly what to do.
Yeah, mental preparation is always very important, and I will speak to Coach about that now. Coach, talk to me about the contingent of swimmers that you've brought here to Kingston, hoping that you can walk away with some of the prizes.
All right, so this year's Goodwill Team Bahamas, we have a contingent of 48 members with 40 swimmers of that contingent. Preparation started from early April. We've been working hard, we selected a team, and we went straight into planning to be here. Former years, we were a little bit late at the blocks, but this year we were way more organized.
Yeah.
And with being more organized, we're looking forward to great performance. Did the preparation, did the mental work, did the nutrition, all of that. Now it's on them to perform.
Yeah, to execute. And
correct.
Coach, who are we to look out for especially? I mean, you've worked with the athletes very, very closely. So we're here looking on SportsMax. Who are we to watch out for from Bahamas?
We have an amazing group of 8 and under girls. From the psych sheet, you could see that they're pretty much blocking out all the top 3 spots.
Wow.
We have some good boys in the 15-17. Caleb Ferguson, Tristan, hard work in the middle. We have Madison Gilbert. We have some good talent. And a whole, we have a really amazing team. And as much as I don't really like to single out, because we operate as one unit.
Correct.
And at the end of the day, you know, we're all going to be Team Bahamas, should everything finish in our favor, to be number one.
Yeah. Toby, tell me a bit about the events you will be taking part in, and a bit about some of your teammates as well.
Okay, so I'm taking part in 100 backstroke, 100 freestyle, also 50 freestyle, 50 backstroke, 50 butterfly.
Wow.
200 freestyle, and
so
200 I am. Everything but breaststroke.
Okay.
And my favorite event of all time is 100 meter butterfly.
Yeah.
And my teammates are really supportive. They'll make some like jokes here and there that could be insulting.
Well, you know.
My club on the whole, which is RWV, it's like a family. Everybody is like literally brother and sisters bond. So you literally feel comfortable. I joined recently this January. And I felt like home instantly, and that just made me feel like to be me. I was comfortable enough to be me and make friends and all.
Right, and it's, you know, you spoke about making jokes, but people only make jokes when they're comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
So clearly I can tell from that you all have a very special bond. Mm-hmm. What are you hoping to achieve, seeing that you're doing all these events?
Mm-hmm.
What are you hoping to achieve for yourself when you walk away from Jamaica?
I'm hoping to at least carry home 2 medals.
Yes.
And I just want to make a name for myself. I want people, they might not know my face, but I want them to know my name,
yes,
most of all.
All right. Well, you heard it from Toby herself. So, Coach, you know, I spoke to her about the preparation coming into this event. But Bahamas, of course, you're the coach, you're thinking big. You want to get the best out of your team from this competition. How important are events like these for the development of swimmers?
Okay, well, the Goodwill meet is they try to keep the undertone of the meet, not to create another character.
Right.
So the expectation and the rules that governs Goodwill is keen. As you know, well, you guys may not know, if you competed in character this year, you're not allowed to take part in Goodwill.
Oh.
Okay. So that's the first thing. And you know, character starts at 11, 12 and up. For Goodwill, it incorporates the 8 and 9 and the 9, 10.
Right.
Right. So it's a development meet, and 90%, close to 100% of the kids who transition from Goodwill in the lower end automatically goes to character.
Yeah.
So it's like a building block, and it gives swimmers an opportunity to represent their country. You know, like sometimes you're locked into the two swimmers always going, you know. So we have options now, and you have other meets and other opportunities to represent your country.
Yeah, what's the swimming program like in Bahamas?
The Bahamas has an amazing program. As you know, they're 5-time champions for Carifta.
Yes.
To hold a title for 5 years, that's depth. And our goal is to further show the extent and how difficult it is to pick the team because of the caliber of swimmers we have and the depth of the team on the lower end and on the top end. Carifta only carries 38. We have 40 now. So we have 38 and 40. That's what, 78 swimmers in that pool. So it's pretty, we have depth, and it's hard work, great coaches, great program, great presidents in the clubs, and absolutely a great federation that has the vision to build an entire program. And to hold it for 5 years for Carifta, you know, it's a game changer.
Yes. And Tony, I know you're still very young, and that's why I'm being very cautious about the questions I ask, because you only joined the team, you said, earlier this year. And I know COVID would have taken away a lot of the things that you probably would have wanted to do in the past 2 years. But based on what you've experienced with the Trinidad and Tobago Swimming, and I sit on this show and I boast about the facilities we have back home, like the National Aquatic Swimming Center, you'll have the opportunity to do that. And I was asked right here, why is it that we don't have much more swimming medals if we have so many good facilities? Mm-hmm. Do you think, you know, based on your talent and the opportunities that you have, that you can change that for us?
Oh, definitely. Next year, my major goal is to make Carifta. And before COVID, I was at like my peak where I was making best times at almost every meet. Then COVID came, so I stopped training. I stopped training for like, I believe, 4 months. Mm-hmm. And I gained a lot of weight, and it was a lot of pressure on me to see all my friends improving, because my parents couldn't afford to send me training at that time.
Right.
So all my other teammates were swimming, and I was just there. And when I joined swimming, I saw all the people that was faster than beating me. Mm-hmm. So it was like a lot of, it was me versus my mind, because my mind would always be like, look at these young children beating you, like you can't have that. So some days I wouldn't feel so good training, because like to see that, but eventually I got over it and just worked in the pool and just had a main battle in the pool. And
you got over it.
Yeah, I got over it.
Yeah. Well, I'm happy to see you at the Goodwill. And now that I've met you, I will be looking forward to seeing your performances come to meet. Coach, anything you want to say to the viewers who will be supporting your country?
Like I said, we come out and support. We have a whole movement of parents behind us this go around. And I'm pretty much sure all the teams have their parents with them and swimmers working that.
Yeah.
But absolutely, man, come out and support and cheer us on, and you know, just have a great weekend of swimming.
Yeah, well, you get to speak to your parents now on this SportsMax Zone. I know they'll be cheering you on because we'll be bringing the event live. So you can probably say something to them.
I just want to say thanks for supporting me and always carrying me from about training, regardless of how much attitude I gave you. And I would say I wouldn't trade any other parents. I'm really proud that you all decided to put me in a sport because I wouldn't have the achievements I have today. So I want to say thank you.
All right, so we are so excited to see the Bahamas team and, of course, Trinidad and Tobago and all the teams taking part in this Goodwill Swimming Meet. And, of course, as we told you earlier, we will be bringing the event live to you on your home of champions. So don't miss it. We have to look out to see what Tony does. All right, let's take a quick break and come right back.